Sebring just an animal in the back of that sled. See that black sled flying through there, didn't touch a wall. That was Lana and H pushing the sled. I would expect that start record to go down right here, and it does. 5'10". Track. You need to have a great start time to be able to hold on to that velocity. It's tough to just keep that speed, you know. Now you're just trying to stay alive. Still seems to have a smile on her face, but I'm not sure how exactly genuine that smile is. Don't it make you smile? Don't it make you smile? She must have had a great bottom half of the track. Once she came out of Kreisel and into the chicanes, into Ekovan, she must have been picking up speed somewhere. Once upon a time, I could control my 540, a rank of 10. You know, she didn't run it as deep. And I think the Canadian team realized that, and as soon as they saw a green light, they decided to go. The deficit she had was gone immediately. You and I were thinking that there's no way she can keep that. You're not going to find a better man to drive this German sled. And he's got a, you know, pretty decent start time. All he needs to do is just breathe as he's going down here.
Stay with me. Let's just breathe.
He's looking pretty smooth. He's got a nice even flow as he comes through curve 5, 6, and 7. Chris does a good job of riding that big wave through there. Yeah, with that big skid coming out of curve 10, you can't keep that great start time that you have. Yeah, she's a tenth of a second back right now, and I don't think she has the speed to make that comeback. Come back. Now you can see the brake person's first few steps, those footsteps in the back. It seemed like her first couple steps were a little bit short. Footsteps in the hole, it wants you. And she uses her sled as the fixer of her runs, you know. Left-hand wall to release that push bar. It's too little, too late. There's nothing that she can do that's really gonna save you at this point. I'm gonna save for her. As opposed to the Russians, she's drifting to the right where the Russians went to the left, but she overcorrected and started to skid, and there she hit that loose entrance. Drifting, drifting, drifting. Brakeman has to take about one breath before they have to pull the brakes. If Kaylee wins this, Tom will definitely be the man of the hour. The man of the hour taken is final. Sanders got to be thinking it's all or none right now. They look at each other as rivals. And I think she has to break that habit of thinking she's the underdog. Coming through the long curve of Kreisel around the bend. There's a sun around the bend. Now I do think we do have to mention that there was a grievance filed yesterday, a protest filed against Friedrich here. Has been very faithful to the Bodine steering for a long time. The Butter had a couple mistakes, something he liked to soon forget. The thin air here in the Alps of St. Moritz, sometimes that plays a little factor. The ice is a little bit thinner. Well, no, Bardis just says, not for you today.
This is not for you!
Not the smoothest exit out of Curve 12, kind of up amongst the waves there. Yeah, fairly smooth from Curve 7 to 8 to 9 out of 10. Nice last exit out of that labyrinth.
But when you see the black, red, and yellow of Germany, it's always an intimidating factor.
Black and red and yellow, black and red and yellow.
So at the beginning of the season, you know, every driver sets goals and, you know, makes up a wish list. And I don't know if...
I wish I was the evidence. I wish I was the sun.
And Kaylee's a little bit of a dissident. You know, she can really use that to fire She got their left runners up on the almost corduroy feeling section of the track, off the ice and up to the ripples. So why go 2 days in a row if you don't have to?
Why go home?
A lot of G-force pushing into that Echovon corner toward the end. You know, it's a force of nature that just presses that brake down.
Understand, she's a force of
sled she's in was given to fly, but it just hasn't found a way to make it click yet this year. So, you know, looking at the glasses half full.
Yeah.
Place, you know, she may be feeling some pressure, some things you might consider insignificant. Yeah, I think Kaylee got some rage in her and she really let it loose.
I got some if you need it.
You know, sometimes you think you're in a great position coming off a curve, but nothing's as it
seems.
They rock the sled and usually use the strength of the girl to move that sled forward. Some people think you need a form of evacuation in order to get out of the sled once there's a crash.
He needs to just watch the rearview mirror.
In my rearview mirror.
I think it's a little bit of an annoyance and it bugs them if they're not the fastest team on this.
I got bugs in my room. Bugs in my bed.
Just movements of a sleight of hand, you know, controls the sled and it makes it really difficult. You feel the push me, pull me feeling as a driver steering back and forth.
Push me, pull me.
Now, Vuk and the Serbian team have kind of been adopted as the daughter program of the German program.
Don't call me, don't ring when it's not been
true. Off he goes, off Sunny into Nash Dixon.
Off he goes with his
Yeah, there's nothing man can do to try to come back from that.
Nothing man.
Frank Wrigley designed this sled not too long ago using a Bodine body and it made a couple modifications. And that Dirty Frank sled right now is really flying. And you have to put it in your pilot's hands, just a state of love and trust, letting the pilot, you know, take you down the rest of the course, not only safe, but fast.
State of love and trust is a force that down
weight. You know, the Americans, we prefer kind of a soft yellow lead, better than some other types of weight you might be able to put into the sled. Time you see the brakeman really bobbing your head back and forth, and that can kind of cause a little bit of a feeling of spin. That black circle of a helmet in front of her is something that she can focus on. It's definitely great. You know, you see an elderly woman behind the counter in a small town like Stamer in Switzerland. When the local crowd comes out, it's always great to see them support not just the Swiss team but all the crowds.
Hearts and thoughts, they fade away. Hearts and thoughts, they fade away. I swear I recognize your breath, memories like fingerprints are slowly raising. Me, you wouldn't recall, for I'm not my former. It's odd when you're stuck upon the shelf.